Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's review the chemistry for making anilines. Anilines are important because they are the direct precursor of diazonium ions. Across the top of the screen is the synthesis of aniline. The key step for making anilines is forming the carbon-nitrogen bond. Traditionally, the nitrogen is first added to the aromatic ring through a nitration, which is something like HNO3 and H2SO4. Once the nitrogen is on the ring, the NO2 group is then reduced to an NH2 group. Over the past 100 plus years of organic chemistry, dozens and dozens of different methods for reducing nitro groups to anilines have been developed. I want to highlight just three of these methods. First, catalytic hydrogenation with H2 and a catalyst like palladium on carbon works well. These are probably the conditions that I show most frequently. There is, however, a catch. H2 and palladium on carbon can do other reactions. You can reduce alkenes, you might also remove aromatic halides, therefore, if you have an isolated alkene in your molecule or a halogen on the ring, the catalytic hydrogenation might not be your best choice. The second option, iron, it's metallic iron, and a weak acid like acetic acid. These conditions are very mild, meaning they normally won't affect other functional groups in a molecule. Note that this reaction involves the reduction of the nitro group. If something is being reduced, then something else must be oxidized. Iron is converted from iron 0, metallic iron, to iron 3, or iron plus 3. Iron is being oxidized as the nitrogen of the nitro group is being reduced. Third option, stannous chloride, that's SnCl2, is another mild reducing agent for nitro groups. The reaction is performed in an alcohol solvent, like ethanol. Again, something must be getting oxidized. In this reaction, the tin atom is going from the plus 2 oxidation state to the plus 4 oxidation state, tin 4. Tin is being oxidized as the nitrogen of the nitro group is being reduced. Once we can reliably make anilines, we are prepared to discuss the synthesis of diazonium ions. And we'll see that in the next video.